What is up guys, कैसे हो आप लोग? So today we are going to ride the Tiger 900 Rally Pro 2024 model. This is the second video in this series about this motorcycle. I already made a video about the 15 major changes that Triumph has made on the 2024 900 Tiger series. So check out that video, you'll be getting a link somewhere up here. That video will be talking about all the changes. In this video, we will be riding this machine. I'll be sharing my feedback of what I think of this machine. For perspective, as I told in the previous video, I had the Tiger 800 for 4 years, and last year I bought a 900 Rally Pro. This is the updated version of that model. When the 900 came to the market, people were kind of talking about the 1-3-2 firing order that Triumph introduced. The benefits were great with the great low end torque, but there were some disadvantages with increased vibrations and lack of smoothness. So Triumph has promised that they have addressed those things. And there are, you know, other changes that I talked about in the previous video. Let's see how all these things come together in today's video. So time to get on the bike and tell you what this machine is really offering. Let's get on this beauty and get started. A good location in Greater Noida with these flower petals fallen on the road and this beauty parked on it. So let's switch this on. First things first. The new TFT display. Now this is something that I don't like. This takes a lot of time, this blackout. Now the screen comes, a good 4 seconds of delay when the screen starts. And this has the new Tiger 1200 display. A beautiful Sunday morning, and although it's getting blistering hot in Delhi, riding a big capacity machine like this, I can't afford to ride slow, huh? You need to keep the gas on and keep having fun. Oh, it's just been like 10-15 seconds on the bike, and I can only tell you one thing that is coming out very, very clearly is the smoothness. So yesterday I was revving this motorcycle on idle, not mad revving, but a little bit of revving. 2,000, 2,500, 3,000 RPM types, and the exhaust sound seemed a lot smoother as compared to the 900 that I have, the previous generation. I'm going to call it previous generation because those comparisons are inevitable, and I'm not going to call my bike as the 2023 Tiger 900 Rally Pro. So I'm not going to use that. I'm going to just use the word or phrase previous generation. This has that punch, man. So like I was telling you, this feels already a lot smoother once we hit on the highways, get on the open roads. I think then we'll know how it feels at 100-120, around 3,000-4,000 RPM. That is where the buzz, a slight buzz, comes on the previous generation. Right now we are just opening the throttle and just touched 100 like this, huh? Amazing feel. Surprisingly, this machine is feeling a lot lighter and nimbler. Figures wise, spec wise, the weight has not been reduced. It's kind of the same thing. But it's maybe just because of the fact that this is a bare bones machine, as in there is no aftermarket accessory installed, no bigger upper crash guard, no bark busters, no pannier racks, all that stuff is not there. So this is feeling a lot lighter. I think this gives me a cue in terms of removing some weight from my 900 Rally Pro, at least get the stuff out which I am not using on a regular basis. Just get to the main road and throttle. No vibes. Even at third gear, 117, it's definitely a big, big change in terms of the smoothness. Now the smoothness, as I was telling you in the previous video, is, arre aunty ji, was because of the
vibration dampening that has happened at the base of this handlebar, that layer of dampening that is provided to ensure that the handlebars do not get those vibrations. I'm not sure whether that can be fitted on the previous gen. If it can, then I'm definitely getting that, because it's clearly working amazingly well. What do you guys think of the screen, the new design? I'm also looking at this TFT display as we are riding. The design of the display is something that is of personal choice. I prefer the previous Gen 900 display. One, I do not like this roundish dial look. And apart from the layout, if you just toggle this switch left, you see this display moving. That whole movement is a little laggy. It's kind of the same thing in the 1200 as well. Seems like that graphic that used to come on our Nokia phones, Nokia 2100 or 3300, where those two hands used to meet, laggy. I mean, we are in 2024. I expected a much more responsive display, smoother graphics. This is kind of an eyesore, but otherwise the information layout is pretty good. Big numbers, big gear indicator, all that stuff is there. Now this machine comes in at a 45,000 rupee premium in terms of ex-showroom prices. The previous Gen 900 Rally Pro was 15.85 ex-showroom, or 15.8 ex-showroom to be precise, and this one is 16.25. So a 45,000 rupee premium for all those 15 odd changes that Triumph is offering on this model. Adjao! Really eager to take this left, man, and get on the expressway. Let's go bazooka. Baby, give me some space. Okay, it's not even feeling like a 900cc machine right now. The way it's handling, it's just crisp. So we are at 5,000 rpm. I'm not just revving it unnecessarily, it's just a natural smooth acceleration that I'm giving it, but it's enjoyable. One thing that is also very usable is this Type-C port. Like I was telling in the previous video, you can easily plug in your phone here. I recently invested in a 15 Pro Max, so mounting it here, if I ever have to, is very easy with the Type-C port now being available. The previous gen had a DIN port, and that is a pain in the ass, because a DIN port requires a DIN adapter costing around 3200 rupees. Let's go, baby. I am on the highway, so I need to pull up the windshield, and for pulling up, this thing is there. This bracket is now made of fiber. The previous gen had a metal bracket. Oh, beauty, beauty. Just an exhilarating punch. Wow, man, what a feel. The next question that comes to mind is, what about that 108 bhp of power, which is 14 bhp more than the 94 bhp Tiger 900? Is that something that I can feel? Hell yes. That's a big yes from my side, because the way the power is delivered is amazing. The punch is even more infectious now, and to complement that, the smoothness also makes the whole experience a little more premium, if I may use that word. Wow. Ooh-hoo-hoo. Definitely you can feel that 14 bhp increase in power. Of course, I'm not revving it to the extreme top end because this is a brand new machine. It was ridden just about 7 kilometers when I got my hands on it yesterday. So I'm respecting the constraints about rev limits in the early phase of the motorcycle, kind of respecting, not totally respecting, you know what I mean. But all the acceleration that I'm doing is I'm trying to do it in a very smooth manner. The 3 Nm increase in torque, yeah, I mean, it's feeling responsive, so might be it can be attributed to that. The growl from the exhaust is amazing. Not sure if you guys can hear it. Overtaking a GS here, I also see a Interceptor 650. Let's eat that up. Sorry, huh? Wrong word. Let's overtake it easily. Oh, crazy good. This is the speed run that really makes you feel alive. Another major thing that I was expecting to be improved on this new gen Tiger was the direction of the heated air or warm air that was coming from the radiator fans. Now we know that in the 900 series the fan direction is like this, I mean it's facing that side, pushing out all the air like this coming towards you and hitting your knees. In this model they have added those winglets to redirect the air. Are they effective? I'm on the fence about it because right now on the highway I can still feel a little bit of warm air hitting my shins. In the previous gen, the one that I have, the air is hitting my knees. Here it's hitting my shins. So just that direction is altered a little. Even at highway speeds, I'm able to feel that hot flow of air from the radiator fans. Mind you, we are riding in 35 degrees Celsius right now. This is peak, kind of peak summers in Delhi NCR. The temperature is going to about 40, 41, 42. It's 8:51 a.m. So, yeah. So in a nutshell, that winglet thing is not working great. That's my take on it. There are aftermarket accessories available that change the airflow. I saw one which costs around 10,000 rupees, a piece of fiber again that can be put on both sides. Maybe that's something that's the way to go. Massive pull. Definitely that increase in power is clearly visible. Can be felt very clearly. Now what this will translate to is I think the top end becoming even more meatier. The previous gen would kind of struggle to reach 200. This one I think can easily cross 205, 207. Would you end up riding your ADV like that? Not sure, but the way this thing accelerates in the usable power band is completely different. After talking about all these things, I think the one thing that will come to mind of all the existing 900 Tiger owners, is this worth an upgrade? Now, that's a very, very tricky question. See, when we choose these bigger capacity motorcycles, the least we expect is refined, smooth performance, vibe-free ride experience at high speeds. This generation of the Tiger 900 series offers that huge improvement. Like I said, I would consider myself a little unlucky that I got the previous gen Tiger. If I would have waited for an year, maybe I could have gotten this new model. This is a big game changer to the 900 series. If you own the previous gen Tiger 900, should you upgrade to this? I don't think so, because you will be incurring a big loss if you bought this motorcycle like me last year or maybe a year before that. But if you got the first lot of the 900, say in 2021, and it's already been 3 years, then maybe you can definitely look at it as an upgrade. Sell the previous gen, get this new gen, and it will be an amazing transformative ride experience. This kind of sits in between the 800 and the previous gen 900 in terms of smoothness. 800 being the super smooth, silky smooth engine from Tiger, from Triumph on the Tiger 800s, and the previous gen 900s being the roughest Tiger that everyone has possibly seen. This kind of sits in the middle. Talking about the competition in the market right now, I know these are great times in the Indian motorcycling space. Some good motorcycles that have recently come up: Honda Transalp, there is the Suzuki V-Storm 800DE. None of those motorcycles have the same excitement that the Tiger would offer. I know that some people would just compare prices and round off and say things that the 800DE is what, 12 lakhs on road, and the Transalp is also kind of in that 12-13 lakh range, and the Tiger will be easily touching around 17.5-18. But the performance that you will be getting on a Tiger is unparalleled. And apart from that, there is this thing which I am just not able to understand about some manufacturers. Honda and Suzuki, you guys made your motorcycles with ride-by-wire throttle and you did not offer cruise control on a 13 lakh rupee motorcycle. Come on guys, I mean, this is really bullshit. There are people who think that cruise control is not usable in India. If you know how to use it, it's an amazing feature when you are out touring. And none of these two motorcycles, the Transalp and the 800DE, offer cruise control even after having a ride-by-wire system. Guys, if you don't want to offer cruise control, then why don't you at least offer it as an option, as an accessory? You're not even doing that. This is really crazy, in my opinion. So that is only on offer on the Tiger 900, and that swings things in favor of this machine, even though it's a lot pricier. There is one more machine that people evaluate in this segment, which is the BMW 850 GS. I personally do not like that machine. It feels a lot rough compared to the previous gen. Yeah, it was equally rough, but after riding this 2024 version of the Tiger, I feel this is much more smoother than the BMW 850 GS. If I were in the market right now, this would be a no-brainer for me again. So that's my verdict about this machine. I hope it answers a lot of questions. There are not many reviews as we speak right now of actual ride experience in India of this machine. Any other questions that you have, I am open to answering on the comments that you'll be posting down, or reach out to me on Instagram, 23rides, same handle, DM me. I'll be happy to answer questions about this beautiful machine. So that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.